Welcome everyone. So we started the new chapter, Strategies for Enhancement in Food Production. In that, in the first lecture, we completed dairy farm management. In the second lecture, we completed poultry farm management. Now in today's lecture, we will discuss about the next topic, that is animal husbandry or animal breeding, right? So our today's topic is animal breeding. Now, what is meant by breeding? Like breeding between the animals, between male and female, between superior male and superior female. It comes under animal breeding, right? So breeding of animals means mating of animals is called breeding of animals. Breeding of animals is an important area, it's an important aspect in animal husbandry, because when you select a superior female and a superior male and then we mate them, so when we breed them, so then we get advanced characters in the progeny, right? So that is why they're telling animal breeding is an important area in animal husbandry. Now, animal breeding aims in, these are the sentences which I took from NCRT. Animal breeding aims in, what is the aim of animal breeding? Now, what is the aim of a student who joined 11th and 12th? They want to crack NEET entrance examination so that they can get MBBS seat or medical seat. In the same manner, what is an aim of animal breeding? So the aim of animal breeding is to increase the yield, right? For example, a cow which is giving 10 liters of a milk a day, we want to increase it to 20 liters. So means increase in yield is one aim in animal breeding. Other one, improving the desirable qualities. So in the cow's milk, we want to increase the protein content, we want to increase the sugar content. So increasing the quality and increasing the yield. So these are the aims of animal breeding. Understood, children? That's what NCRT says. Like, what are the aims of animal breeding? Means increasing the yield is one aim, and improving the quality is the other aim. And then in NCRT, they have asked a series of questions. So I wrote the questions here and let us try to solve the answers for that, right? The first question what they have asked in NCRT is, for what kind of characters would we breed the animals? Means expecting which characters are we doing the animal breeding, are they asking us. Just now we told we want high yield, that is our aim, right? We want high yield, we want good growth rate or high growth rate. If the growth rate is good, then the animal will grow more, it eats more and it yields more. So high yield, high growth rate and improved quality. So these are the characters what we look when we are doing animal breeding. That's what they asked. Let me write down the answer. For what kind of characters would we breed animals? Means for characters like, for high yield is one character. The next one is for high growth rate. For high growth rate is the next character. And the other one is for improved quality. So right, third one is for improved. We want to improve the quality also of the breed. Improved quality. So these are the few characters which we look when we are doing animal breeding. So this is the answer, children. Note it down. Next one. Next question what they ask in NCRT is, would the selection of the character differ with the choice of the animal? Would the selection of the character differ with the choice of the animal? We have to tell yes. The selection of the character differs with the choice of the animal. For example, when you are choosing an animal which is a layer, like a chicken, you are choosing which is a layer. So then our selection of character should be, it has to lay more eggs. It should not be like it should lay more, it should give more meat, right? So the selection of the character, what character are you selecting, depends upon the choice of the animal. So let me write down, selection of character differs with the choice of the animal. Yes, it differs, right? So selection of character, It depends on the type of the animal. On the type of the animal. For example, let me give you here, in chicken we have layers, we have broilers. Layers are the animals or the fowls which are meant only for laying the eggs. Broilers are the animals which are meant for, or the fowls which are meant for laying meat, meant for giving meat. So selection of characters depend upon the type of the animal. For example, layers, right? So if layer, then what should be the character? The character should be egg production. If you are taking an animal like layer, then which character you need to select? You need to select egg production. Other one, if you are taking broilers, then what character do you need to select? You need to select the meat production, right? The character should be meat production, children. Did you understand this question and explanation? Right? Now let's go to the next question. They're asking us, can you define what is breed? And in NCERT, they have given the definition also for this question, what is breed? Now breed, they're telling, they are a group of animals. Breed means it is a group of animals. They are related by descent, means they come from the common ancestry. Breed means a group of related animals. They are related by descent, means they have common ancestry. Since they're having common ancestry, they'll be similar in most of the characters. In appearance they are similar, in features they are similar, in size they are similar, in configuration they are similar, in qualities they are similar. Understood, children? For example, you're seeing some cows are grazing. So in that, if you see all the cows which are of the same breed, they move together. So means they are from the same descent, right? So come on, let us tell what is the definition of a breed. Breed is a group of animals. So they are related by descent, means they are having common ancestry. Since they are having common ancestry, common father and common mother, they'll be similar in most characters, like general appearance, like features, like size, configuration, all those things. Let us write on. So what is a breed? A group of animals. Group of animals. These animals are descends from a common ancestor. They are descends from common ancestor. They are descends from common ancestor, and they have similar characters, right? And have most of the characters similar. What are the characters which are similar for this group of animals? The characters which are similar are, we can tell, general appearance. Let us write on. Which are similar are general appearance, then general features, size, shape, configuration, etc. So a group of animals which are descending from the common ancestor, they have similar characters in appearance, in size, in shape, in configuration, then you call it as a breed, right? So we'll understand even more better when we take the examples and we go. Now I want to clarify one more point here. If you want to differentiate a breed from a species, what it is? Now breeds means breeds are different types within the same species. In the cow itself we have different breeds, in buffalo we have different breeds, in chicken we have different breeds. So breed means they are different types of the same species, right? So where shall I write down? Here I am writing out. So breeds are different types of same species. So this is the difference between breed and the species. Breeds are different types of the same species. Now in the next question, in NCERT they asked us, find out the names of some common breeds for cattle and poultry. They asked, cattle means usually cows and buffaloes. Do you know the scientific name of buffalo? Do you know the scientific name of buffalo? Let us write down. The species buffalo. Buffalo is a species. Its scientific name is, what is the scientific name? Bubalus. Bubalus, we can tell. What is it? Bubalus. 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 Or we can also write it as Bos taurus also. It is also called Bos taurus. So buffalo is called Bubalus. Bubalus, it is called Bos taurus. Now if we have to see, what is this? This is a species. Now if we have to see the breeds, if we have to see the breeds of buffalo, what are the breeds of buffalo? Jafarwadi, Murrah, Meshana, Surti, all these are the names under the species called buffalo. So if we have to see the breeds, I'm writing down the breeds of buffalo. What are the breeds of the buffalo? Murrah is one breed. Jafarwadi is another breed. Surti is another breed. Meshana is another breed. So these are different breeds. These are the names of different breeds under buffalo. Understood, children? Take a screenshot. Then we will talk about the breeds of cow also. So what did I try to tell you in this board? So we are talking about the next topic, which is animal breeding. And we are telling animal breeding is an important area in animal husbandry. And the aim of animal breeding is to increase the yield and to improve the quality. Now then, what kind of characters would you choose in parents when you are doing a breeding? Means we choose high yielding variety, we choose high growth rate, and we choose high quality, like that. Now what would the selection of the character differs with the choice of the animal, right? It differs. Now if you are choosing an animal like a fowl, like a layer, then the character should be, it has to lay more eggs. And if you are choosing an other animal, other bird, which is called broiler, then your character should be more meat production. Now what is breed? I have given the definition of the breed, and I try to differentiate the breed from a species. Now if you see the species, it is buffalo. The scientific name of buffalo is Bivalis bivalis, or we can call it as Bos taurus. Now under this species buffalo, what are different breeds we have? Murrah is one breed, Jafarbadi is another breed, then Sruti and Meshana are the different breeds of buffalo. Take a screenshot, then we will talk about cows and their breeds. Right, children, can I erase this? Now we'll talk about cow breeds also. First of all, we'll try to identify the scientific name of the cow. Now buffalo is called Bos taurus, cow is called Bos indicus, and we will see the breeds of cow. Now if the cow, it's an Indian cow, then we call it indigenous, desi cow. And if it is from another place, exotic we call, right? So another species we'll take, what is that? Cow, right? Now what is the scientific name of cow? The scientific name of cow is called Bos indicus. Okay, its scientific name is Bos indicus. Now when we have to see different breeds of cow, now indigenous breed means desi breed. Under indigenous breed, the cow which is meant for milk production is called as milch breed. The cow which is meant for other purposes, means if it is meant for other purpose, means for bullock carting and all, if it is used, then that is called draught breed. If it can give milk also and it is used for other agricultural purposes also, that's called dual breed. So indigenous cows only we can divide them into milch breed, draught breed, and dual breed. Now let us talk about milch breed first. Now when we have to talk about their breeds of cow, under that milch breed, right? Under milch breed, if we have to see the names of milch breed, Gir is one milch breed, Sahiwal cow is another milch breed, Red Sindhi, these are the cows, are the breeds of the cows which give more milk, so that's why they're called as milch breeds. So Gir is one variety, Sahiwal is another breed, Red Sindhi is another breed, comes under milch breeds. The second one is draught breed, used in agricultural purposes. Ongole, Haryana, draught breeds, Malvi, we can take the example. Next one is, children, draught breed. Now what do you mean by draught breed? So milk production will be less, it is used for agricultural purposes. Here we have to take Malvi and Nagore as examples. The cow breed names are, one is Malvi and the other one is Nagore. These are examples of draught breeds. And the third breed is there, which is called as dual breed. Dual breed means it can give milk also, it can be used for agricultural purposes also. Ongole, Haryana comes under dual breeds. Ongole, Haryana comes under dual breeds. Now these are indigenous breeds, right? I told these three comes under which type of breeds? Indigenous breeds. What do you mean by indigenous breed? Indigenous breed means it is called as desi breed. Now if we have to list down the examples of exotic breeds, exotic means foreign breeds. I'll give the examples for exotic also.
Exotic breed. Amma, what do you mean by exotic breed? I told, exotic breed means it's not native of India. It's called foreign breed. Now, Jersey cow is not a native of India. So, brown Swiss is not a native of India. So, examples for exotic breeds are, one we can take Jersey and the other one we can take brown Swiss. So, we are seeing some examples, not all the examples. So, the species, it is cow. Its scientific name is Bos indicus. Under that, what are the breeds? We are calling them as indigenous breeds. We are calling them as exotic breeds. Indigenous means desi breeds. Exotic means, so these are the breeds from different places. Now, under indigenous, if it is milk yielding, milch breed. If it is for agricultural purposes, milk is poor, it's called drought breed. And dual, it can give milk also. It is used for agricultural purpose also, dual breed. Understood, children? So, we have seen buffalo in the previous board. We have seen different species and different breeds of cow here, and we'll talk about chicken also. Next species, this is what the question they asked. So find out the names of few breeds of cattle and poultry. We are seeing the breeds of cattle now, poultry now. The species, it is chicken, right? Do you know the scientific name of chicken? Do you know the scientific name of chicken? In lecture number 2, I mentioned it's called Gallus gallus. What's the scientific name of chicken? It is called Gallus gallus. I told it's tautonomy. If the genus name and the species name are the same, like Naza Naza, right? It is called Gallus gallus here for chicken. It's called tautonomy. Now, let us see different breeds of chicken. Now, if the chicken, in the previous board we have seen, if the chicken is meant for laying eggs, it's called layer. If the chicken is meant for giving meat, broiler. If it can lay egg and give meat also, it is dual breed. Let us write on. So, we are talking about different breeds. Now, under breeds, I'm telling one breed is called layers. Now, layers means they are meant for laying eggs, right? Example, Highline is one breed and the other one is Keystone is another breed. Example for layers are Highline is another breed and Keystone is another breed. So, they will give more eggs. Next one is broiler breed. Amma, what do you mean by broiler breed? Means it is meant for more meat production, right? So, Wenkop, Hubbard are the examples of broiler breeds of chicken. So, examples are Wenkop and Hubbard. And third one I told, dual purpose. Dual breeds means they can lay eggs also. They are used for meat production also. The examples of dual breeds are Chittagong and Gagas, right? The examples of dual breeds are Chittagong and Gagas. Chittagong and Gagas are examples of dual breeds. Again, layers, broilers, dual breeds, whatever the examples I took, all these are indigenous breeds of chicken. These are indigenous chicken breeds. Now, if we want to see exotic breeds like this, so we'll see some exotic breeds also. Amma, what do you mean by exotic breed? Exotic breed means it is foreign breed. Examples for foreign breed. Leghorn is a foreign breed, right? Leghorn is a foreign breed. And then, Leghorn, they have given in the NCERT textbook. So, we can take Leghorn as a foreign breed. So, these are the breeds and the species of cattle and poultry. Take a screenshot. We will continue. Right. So, animal husbandry includes not only rearing cattle like cows and buffaloes and chicken. It also includes some other animals, rearing of pig also, rearing of sheep also, rearing of goat also, right? We will see the scientific names and why are they reared. What products we get, that also we will see before going into animal breeding topic. So, we tell in animal husbandry, we rear different animals which give economically useful products for the man. So, like that, if you see pig, we'll see the scientific name of the pig and what products we expect from the pig, we will see. In the similar manner for goat and sheep also, we will see. Then we will get into the topic of exactly what is animal breeding. So, when we have seen about buffalo, then we talked about cow, then we talked about chicken. Now let's talk about pigs also.
Do you know what's the scientific name of pig? It is Sus scorpha. What is that?
S-U-S, Sus scorpha
is the scientific name of the pig. Sus scorpha is the scientific name of the pig. Why do we rear pigs? So for the fat, for the meat, and for the skin. It is the hide. So pigs are reared.
They are reared for fat and for meat and for their animal skin, which is called animal hide, from which we make leather.
So pigs, they grow very fast, and so they are called as meat machines. They can give more amount of meat when compared to the other animals, right? So what's the scientific name of pig? The scientific name of pig is Sus scorpha. It is reared for obtaining meat. Next one is fat. Next one is animal hide. Next one, we'll talk about sheep also. The fifth one is sheep.
Now come on, tell me,
what is the scientific name of sheep? The scientific name of sheep is called Ovis aeris. What is the scientific name?
O-V-I-S. Aeris.
So what's the scientific name of this? It's called Ovis aeris, right? So this is the scientific name of sheep. And why do we rear sheep? For their meat and for their wool, right? So sheep is reared.
It is reared for wool and mutton, right, children?
Now, another thing also comes into your mind when we're talking about mutton, that is goat. Now, kapra, kapra is the scientific name of goat. What's the scientific name of goat?
It is kapra. Kapra means, this is also tautonym. The genus name and the species name means the same.
Again, goat is called as poor man's cow. So it gives more amount of milk, right? So goat is also called as,
it is also called as poor man's cow.
And so why do we rear goat? Come on, tell me. We rear goat again for their milk and meat. So we rear it.
They are reared for the meat and milk,
right? So the from Pashmina wool, we tell. Pashmina wool is obtained from Kashmiri goats. So it is of high quality wool that we can mention here.
Pashmina wool we call.
And this Pashmina wool is extracted from which type of goats? Kashmiri goats.
Pashmina wool is high quality wool. Obtained from which breed? It is obtained from a breed. What is it called? Kashmiri breed. From Kashmiri breed of goat we obtain.
And have you heard of another, Angora wool? Angora wool means it is obtained from rabbit skin.
If we are talking about wool, let us take another wool also. Angora wool. And this wool is obtained from rabbit. Right, children?
So we rear rabbit for taking the wool. We rear goats for taking the wool, meat and milk. We rear sheep for wool and mutton. And pig we rear for fat, meat and animal hide. Right, children? So they asked us to find out the names, find out the breeds, right? We have taken so many breeds. So buffalo breeds we have taken, cow breeds we have taken, chicken breeds we have taken. And we told that animal husbandry means rearing of other animals, domesticated animals like pig, goat, sheep. So I just mentioned here pig, its scientific name, why it is rare for. Sheep, what is the scientific name? What is it rare for? Goat, scientific name, what is it rare for? Take a screenshot, then we will get into the topic, animal breeding. Right? So we discussed that what is animal breeding. Animal breeding means it is mating of animals, right? Now there are two types of animal breedings, inbreeding and outbreeding. Now let us see what is the difference between inbreeding and outbreeding. So we can tell
animal breeding is of two types. What are the two types of animal breeding? One is called as inbreeding and the other one is called as outbreeding. Now, what do you mean by inbreeding and what do you mean by outbreeding? So, if the breeding is done between the same breed, if the breeding is done between the same breed, means Jersey cow with Jersey cow, Sahiwal cow with Sahiwal cow only, then that is called as inbreeding. Got the point? Breed, if you are breeding them within the same breed and they should have the common ancestor also, then it is called as inbreeding. What is inbreeding? Come on, tell me. Breeding means mating between the same breed. We are breeding between the same breed who are closely related to each other. What do you mean by closely related? Means they are having common ancestors. When we go back and see for the past 4 to 6 generations, they are having the common ancestors. Then that is called as inbreeding. Again, what is inbreeding? Breeding within the same breed. Means Sahiwal cow breeded with Sahiwal cow only. Jersey with Jersey only. That is called as inbreeding. So if you want examples to understand it better, I'm telling Jersey, if it is crossed with Jersey, it is inbreeding. Sahiwal cow, if it is breeded with, if it is crossed with, again Sahiwal only, then it is also called inbreeding. Now coming to outbreeding. If inbreeding is breeding between the same breed, outbreeding will be breeding within the different breeds, right? So outbreeding means it is breeding between the individuals, breeding between the individuals of different breeds. Now again, broadly if you divide and see, outbreeding is of three types. What are the three types of outbreeding? What are the three types of outbreeding? Children, one type of outbreeding is called as outcrossing. The first one of outbreeding is called as outcrossing. And the second one is called as crossbreeding. And the third one is called as interspecific hybridization. What's the third one called? It is called as interspecific hybridization. Carefully follow. So many times they have asked NEET questions on what is outbreeding. So this is important in terms of NEET children. Come on, listen carefully. Inbreeding means breeding within the same breed. Jersey with Jersey, Sahiwal with Sahiwal is called as inbreeding. Now outbreeding. Outbreeding means we are having three types. One is called outcross. Second one is called crossbreeding. Third one is called interspecific hybridization. In outcrossing, we will cross, we will mate between the same breed. They are from the same breed, but they don't have common ancestors for the past 4 to 6 generations. Listen carefully. What is outcrossing? Outcrossing means it is breeding between the same breed. We are breeding between the same breed, but they don't have common ancestors, they do not have common ancestors. They do not have common ancestors for the past 4 to 6 generations. Then that is called as outcrossing. So in outcrossing, if you want the example, we need to tell Jersey crossed with Jersey only. Here also I told Jersey crossed with Jersey is inbreeding. But then they are relatives. They are closely related because they are having common ancestor. Here Jersey with Jersey only. But one Jersey is in one place and another Jersey is completely far away from there. It's in another place and they don't have the common ancestors, right? So if they don't have the common ancestors but they are of the same breed, then that is called outcrossing. Second one is crossbreeding. Crossbreeding means between two different breeds. So breeding between two different breeds. If we are breeding between two different breeds, that is crossbreeding. This you can understand it. So in NCERT, they have given example, like what they have given, Bikaneri Eves. Bikaneri Eves and Merino Rams. They have taken a sheep. One is Bikaneri Eve, other one is Merino Ram. So this is different breed and this is different breed. And what did they get from this? Bikaneri Eves and Merino Rams, they crossed and they got a new breed called Hisardale. They got a new breed called Hisardale. So Hisardale is an example of crossbreeding. What is crossbreeding? It is breeding between two different breeds, right? So you get a new breed which is called as Hisardale. Now coming to interspecific hybridization, breeding between two different species itself. What is interspecific hybridization? This is breeding between two different species, among two different species itself, like horse and donkey. Horse is one species, donkey is another species. Take an example here. So breeding between horse and donkey, so then what do you get? Mule or henny, right? So this we will see clearly in the next lecture. We will see in detail about inbreeding and we will see in detail about outbreeding. Here we have just taken an overview of it. Inbreeding means breeding between the same breed who are having common ancestors. Outbreeding, in that the first one is outcrossing. In outcrossing, we are telling we are breeding between the same breed but they don't have common ancestor. In crossbreeding, we are telling breeding between two different breeds only. One is Bikaneri Eve, next one is Merino Ram. Two different breeds. We got a third breed, superior breed called Hisardale. And the third one is called as interspecific hybridization. Interspecific. Two different species. Now, one species is horse, the other species is donkey. Then we get a different one, different breed called as mule or henny. So in the next lecture, we will talk about inbreeding and outbreeding in detail. If you like the content, like, share, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.